Hello and nice to meet you through this video. We have moved into a new year and I bless you in this new year. And it's a year which I say was waiting on the Lord. In the last year, the Lord said it's going to be an year of open door. And he gave me the scripture from Revelation chapter 3 verse 8. It's a beautiful scripture, by the way. It says that though you had little strength and denied not my name and have kept my word, behold, I set before you an open door and no man shall shut it. What an awesome promise. God is telling you this year, no matter wherever you are watching this, or wherever you are at life, in whatever difficult situation, maybe you're surrounded by so many closed doors in your life. But God is telling you, do not give up. Because doors will close all around you. But I will give you an open door. As you are listening to this message, you are coming under the anointing that is behind this promise. It is the anointing of an open door. So this anointing in this word, Revelation 3:8, the prophetic word, will give you an open door in your life. What an awesome thing. Don't give up. So the Lord is telling us right from that scripture, He's telling us three things. Number one, you had little strength. Number two, you did not deny my name. Number three, you have kept my word. And so I give you an open door. You see, always God gives us certain guidances before he gives us a promise. Now, it's not only that these are conditions. I don't see them as conditions. Because whatever we receive from God is not by fulfilling conditions. If we fulfill conditions and God is going to do it to us, then it means that God is obligated to do it to us because of what we do. No, absolutely not. We receive everything by grace through faith. So we cannot boast, oh, I did this and God did that. No, no, no. It's only through His grace we receive. But then, to receive the grace of God, we have to put ourselves in the right place. It's as simple as this. Let me give you an example. Now, you need to get a bucket of water. The bucket is empty. And there is water in the pipe. There is water in the tank. So what has to be done? You turn, open the pipe, and you have to move the bucket straight under the pipe. Now, you don't call it as a condition. You don't call it as a big effort. You know, if you're going to compare it to filling the water tank, it's nothing. It's an effortless effort, just moving the plastic bucket under the tap. And you have to see to that the bucket is open, right side up. It's not the other way around. Because if it is going to be upside down, it's not going to fill. So put the bucket right side up, open the tap, you're filled. And just exactly like that, God's giving us a few guidances. As easy as putting the bucket under the tap the right way. Number one, you are a weak person. That's what God says. You were weak. You have little strength. All through the scriptures, we find that God's strength is revealed in our weakness. He chooses the weak to confound the strong. He chooses the people who are base to confound those who are lofty, high. He chooses those who are foolish to confound the wise. Why? because glory will go to him. So number one, we need to accept, Lord, it's not my strength, it's your grace. I'm trusting you and your strength. I'm just believing. Secondly, he says, you did not deny my name. Now that's where we need to understand. What is the opposite of denying the name of God? Honoring his name. So this year, always choose to honor his name wherever you may stand. You know, like Shadrach, Meshach, Abednego, the three young men, they stood and honored the name of God before the king. They said, we will give God the glory and we will not give anyone else the glory. And what had happened was God came into the fire as the fourth person, I believe, as the first person, and he quenched the fire. Daniel stood for God's name. The lions became like little puppies. Their mouth were bound by the angel. Mordecai stood for God's glory. He said, I won't bow to a Haman. I will bow to the God of glory. And Haman was eliminated. He tried to eliminate Mordecai, but Haman was eliminated and Mordecai was exalted. Every time you choose to honor the name above all names, you will never go down. You will go up, even if you lose something. It's going to be for a season. And Jesus says, whatever you've lost, hundredfold, you'll receive in this earth and eternal life in heaven. Not only that, you kept my word. The third point is, the Lord says in Revelation chapter 3, verse 8, because you kept my word, you hold on to the word of God. Confess the word of God. Because the word of God is the will of God. There's no word powerful, more powerful than the word of God. Hold on to his word. Read his word. Study his word. Meditate his word. I would encourage you, if you're not been studying your Bible or doing it, not doing it regularly, start it today. Start from the Gospel of John. Start studying every day, a chapter every day, or whatever you can. Read it every day, expecting God to speak to you. Believe the word. Act on the word. And the word will create your world. And with these three things, we have to know that it's not our strength and trust on God's strength. We have to honor him at every situation, and we need to hold on to the word. And you do this, and God is telling, I'm setting an open door before you. And he says, behold, that means it's just nearby. You're not going to see it after a year. No. It's just before you. That's why he says, behold, that means it's invisibility. I set an open door before you, and no man on earth, no man under heaven will be able to shut it. Nobody means nobody. That means when God opens, it's opened for good. It's opened for you, and you will go in and experience the great life that God has for you this year. Be blessed. Be blessed. I want to encourage you, and we want to keep doing this. Please let us know how this has blessed you. We're praying for you. Because right now we just completed our 21-day fasting prayer, and we have prayed for you. I've prayed for you. And we're believing God for great things in your life. May God bless you. Bye-bye.